spoke out for human rights. So they took away his acting jobs. His father came from the Caribbean in the early 20th century. He studied the violin and performed in the concert hall, but soon he began to notice how white were their orchestras. He ran away to a racetrack and learned to ride a horse. He quickly became a jockey, and one more than he lost. But the era of black jockeys was in the 19th century. Only white now allowed to ride in their Kentucky Derby. They called in Canada and was Broadway's native son. He spoke out for human rights, so they took away his dad. So Lee took up boxing, fought well in the ring. He won more than he lost, and was renamed Canada. To fight, for in the roaring 20s, welterweight champs could be only white. But boxing can be brutal, and the head he got hit one night, the blow that caused that damage, and one eye he lost his sight. Retiring from the ring, he formed himself a band, yet gigs were hard to find, so he hunted. They called him Canada Lee, and he was Broadway's native son. He spoke out for human rights, so they took away his acting job. Federal Theater in an uptown Harlem church. They discovered that he could act if the role was realistic. In Stevedore and the Big White Bar, in Native Son, his big hit. Thank you. fight for equality. It's seldom seen as a commune for acting in body and soul.